السلام عليكم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ربي زدني علما صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وبارك وسلم. Today our topic is organism and their environment. Organism and their environment. We know that the organisms living in particular area interact with not only the other organisms but the environment itself. The organisms are the biotic components of an ecosystem. Before that, I want to tell you about the ecosystem. That what is ecosystem? Ecosystem is actually the interaction between the biotic components and the abiotic components of the ecosystem. Biotic components are the living components, the living part of any environment, while the abiotic components are the non-living part of any environment. The living parts are the plants, animals, microorganisms, while the non-living parts, that is abiotic, are the non-living components, that is air, water, soil, etc. So when these two interact with each other, this whole system is known as ecosystem. In an ecosystem, there are some population. Population are the group of same species. And when all different species are living together, they form the community of that ecosystem. And wherever an organism is living, it is known as its habitat or nick. These are the basic terms which have been used when we are discussing the ecosystem and the environment. Okay, when we are talking about the environment, an ecosystem, we know that there should be some source of energy. And in an ecosystem, the main source of energy is sun. The sun is the basic source of energy which is struck by the photosynthetic organism, that is the plants. Plants trap that sunlight and use it in making the food. Energy is stored as a chemical energy in that organism, that is in plant. Energy is stored in it. And some of the energy is eventually lost to the environment as well. So basic source of energy in a biological system is sun. Okay, we know that the energy is trapped in the producers, the plant. Now this energy is shifted to another organism. It means that it flows to another organism. So a way of showing the flow of energy between organism starting from the producer is known as a food chain. That food chain is a flow of energy. Like flower is the producer. Then from flower, a caterpillar eat on it, live on it. It's a primary consumer. From caterpillar, sparrow has eaten that caterpillar, which is a secondary consumer. And then the eagle live on that sparrow is a tertiary consumer. How is energy transferred between organism in a food chain? energy is transferred from different energy level from one level to another. These energy level are known as trophic level. And we can say trophic level is the position of an organism's hold in a food chain or food web or pyramid of a number or pyramid of a biomass. We know what is food chain. Food chain is a flow of energy from one organism to another, and many food chains form food web. The food chains which are interconnected with each other, they form the food web. And pyramid of numbers and pyramid of biomass, we will discuss later on. Okay, why the energy which is transferred is not 100% efficient? Because energy is lost through different methods during this nutrition process, like ingestion, removal of feces. If anyone has eaten on any organism, it's not going to digest each and everything. Only few part is digested by the other organism, while most of the part is removed from the body in the form of feces, excretion, removal of waste, that is urine, respiration also releases some part of energy. The production of inedible bones and shells. Why food chains usually have fewer than 5 trophic levels? Biomass transfer are not 100% efficient, and so there is often not enough energy to support 5 trophic levels. Some of the energy is lost, and when we are talking about the transfer of energy, so after the 5 trophic level, the energy is supply, energy transfer is not as that efficient. That's why we consider only 5 levels basically. Plant is the basic source and efficient supply of food to the humans. Your plants can be used for livestock. Waste energy as the biomass transfer are not 100% efficient. Eating plant transfers can maximize the amount of energy gain as there is only one transfer. We have discussed in the class as well that if we want to save energy, it will be much better to eat directly the producer, the first part of the food chain, the first organism of the food chain, instead of eating the other organism in the food chain. It will reserve or conserve the loss of energy in a food chain. What is food web? I told you, multiple interconnected food chains. The food chains which are interconnected, they form a food web. Producer, the organism which produce their own food, usually by the process of photosynthesis. Primary consumer, are those who eat on the producers. Then comes the secondary consumers who eat on the primary consumer, yeah, who feeds on the primary consumer. Okay, identify the producer in this pyramid of biomass. Yes. Okay. Identify the producer in the pyramid of biomass. Yes, the food chain started with the producers, and we can see the D is the producer in this pyramid. How? Because if this is the grass, then the other caterpillar or other organisms are going to eat the grass first, and then they are eaten by the other organisms. Identify the secondary consumer in this biomass, the pyramid, which is formed by the biomass because of the mass of the organism. We can see that if D is the producer, then C will be the primary consumer, and B will be the secondary consumer who is feeding on C. Okay, the other terms which are used are the herbivores. When we are talking about producers, the animals which feed on the producers are known as the herbivores. That is, they eat only plants. Carnivores, the organism that eat animals. And the other kind is the omnivores, which eat on both. Decomposers, when we are talking about any ecosystem, they are decomposers as well. Decomposers are those which break down the dead matter. The matter which is complex organic compound, they change it into simple or inorganic compound that are easily can be mixed with the soil and increase the nutrient material of the soil, and the fertility of the soil is also increased because it gets lots of nutrient, which is helpful for plant growth. Okay, there is another food chain. Grass is eaten by the grasshopper. Grasshoppers are eaten by frog. That is a secondary consumer. Then the frog is eaten by snake, and the snake is eaten by hawk. Producers, that is the grass. Consumer in one consumer, that is first of all, the grasshopper is a consumer because it is consuming the grass producer. Other consumer is the frog, which is consuming the grasshopper, the secondary consumer. Snake is the tertiary, and as it goes on. Okay, we have discussed lots of terms in this which are discussed in this chapter, that the herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, producers, consumers, primary consumers, secondary consumer, tertiary consumers, population, community, habitat, ecosystem, lots of terms which have been used in this chapter. Now it's time that we can discuss the impact of humans on food chains and webs by over-harvesting certain species. These food chains are usually formed by the nature. Everyone is feeding on other, like the carnivores are feeding on herbivores. And naturally, these food chains are formed. And many food chains form food webs, which are interconnected to each other. इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि जरूरी नहीं है कि एक ऑर्गेनिज्म सिर्फ वो एक ऑर्गेनिज्म जो बताया गया उसी को खा रहा है, उसे कोई और ऑर्गेनिज्म भी खा सकता है. अगर एक हॉक स्पैरो को खा रही है तो एक ईगल भी स्पैरो को खा सकती है, या एक ईगल स्नेक भी खा सकती है. तो इस तरह से मुख्तलिफ चीज़ें, अगर हम बात करें तो अगर एक फ्रॉग को जो है अगर एक स्नेक खा रहा है तो ज़रूरी नहीं है, स्नेक जो है वो रैट भी खा सकता है, रैबिट भी खा सकता है, कुछ भी खा सकता है. इसलिए जो फूड चेन्स हैं वो इंटरकनेक्टेड है टू फॉर्म द फूड वेब्स. अच्छा लेकिन अगर हम इंसान एंड इसके अंदर कुछ किसी स्पीशी के ऊपर ज्यादा जो है वो किसी स्पीशी को ज्यादा कर दें और चेंज करें उस नेचुरल जो एक सीक्वेंस चला आ रहा है तो क्या हो सकता है? So many organisms rely on other organisms as a form of their food. Over harvesting can reduce the amount of food available in that particular area for that animal. It will disturb the ecosystem. Another species, if the human introduce in the habitat, what will happen? Introducing new organism increase competition and can interfere with the food chain, causing organisms who cannot compete to die. जाहिर सी बात है अगर जो कमजोर होगा वो अपना खाना नहीं हासिल कर सकेगा तो फाइनली क्या होगा वो स्पीशी मरने लगेगी खत्म होने लगेगी एंड फाइनली A point will come when there is that species becoming extinct. Okay, a pyramid of number shows the number of organism at each trophic level. The other question arises: Why the pyramid of number is not pyramid shaped? Because it does not consider the shape, it considers the number only. Pyramid of number does not take size and mass of organism into account. Biomass, a pyramid that shows the total dry mass of organism at each trophic level. Biomass is the pyramid that shows equal dry mass of the organism at each trophic level. We have gone through this producers kaise pata chalega D hai iske andar. Okay, why the pyramid of biomass is better? Way of representing the pyramid of number. Biomass shows the actual mass of the organism present and not the number actually. Okay, when we are talking about an ecosystem, different nutrient cycles are there going on for recycling the nutrient components of the ecosystem. The decomposers play a very important part in maintaining this nutrient cycles as they help to release the energy and the chemicals from the dead organisms who had used up the energy previously, and now they are decomposed by the decomposers, and the energy which were left in their dead bodies are now easily regained by the soil as they decompose that complex organic compound into inorganic compound, which then mix with the soil and then available for the other organisms. In this, we will study first the carbon cycle. We revise it first. Basically, in carbon cycle, the plant is a basic source for fixing the carbon dioxide component of the ecosystem. How? We know that carbon dioxide is required by the plants to make their food during the process of photosynthesis. And when this carbon containing molecules is eaten by other organisms, this carbon dioxide is shifted to that organism. This carbon dioxide is released by the organisms through respiration, because respiration is a process which is done by all the living organisms. Even the burning of fossil fuels also releases carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. The carbon dioxide component which is saved in the organisms are then returned to the environment by burning fuels, by respiration, and this again utilized by the plants, which uses this organic molecule and convert it into sugar, which is utilized by other organisms. That's how this carbon containing carbon cycle is maintained by the plant. Burning fuel, as I discussed, burning fuel produces carbon dioxide in the environment, smoke, and the release of energy, heat energy, and the carbon dioxide, the burning of fuel. Okay, another factor also affect the concentration of carbon dioxide in the environment, the deforestation. Trees take carbon dioxide during photosynthesis, hence decreasing the atmospheric carbon dioxide concentration. Cutting down trees prevents this, and so the atmospheric carbon dioxide concentration does not decrease and will result into global warming. That is that earth temperature will increase because the carbon dioxide is one of the greenhouse gas that blankets over the earth environment and finally increasing the earth temperature. Then another cycle, the water cycle. You know, water is essential for all the living organisms. We cannot live without water. Even the other organism also cannot live without water. So living organisms require water. And the water cycle provides organism on land with a continuous supply of water. The water cycle, we all know that the basic source of water on earth is the sea. The 3.4 part, the three parts of earth is covered with water. And during the hot summer, sunny days, what happened, the evaporation of water from the sea causes the formation of clouds. These clouds go to the mountains, the higher area. Over there, it rains. And because of this raining, some of the water condenses all over the mountain because of high temperature and less pressure, into ice. And when this ice melts, it forms the streams, and then the streams run into rivers, and then rivers flow into the sea. So that's how this water cycle continuously going on. It supplies the continuous flow of water on land and in the ecosystem. Then comes another cycle, which is known as nitrogen cycle. Nitrogen cycle, nitrogen, you know that air is composed of almost 79% of nitrogen. And nitrogen component of the environment is fixed by lightning and the bacteria. The bacteria which act as a decomposer in soil. Lightning, actually when lightning takes place, the nitrogen combines with oxygen of the air and forms nitrogen oxide. This nitrogen oxide, when it rains, forms the nitric acid and it flows on earth. When an organism dies, the bacteria decompose that organism, the protein in that organism, into simple forms. The decomposers break that matter down into ammonium ion, then this ammonium ion is converted into nitrites and nitrates by the nitrifying bacteria. Plants are able to absorb the nitrate ions. And these nitrites and nitrate ions are by the denitrifying bacteria to gain the nitrogen component of the atmosphere again. The four roles of bacteria during the nitrogen cycle is decomposition, that is decomposing the dead material. Nitrification, that is the converting ammonia into nitrites and nitrates. The converting nitrites and nitrates into nitrogen is denitrification. And nitrogen fixation, there are some bacteria in the nodules of roots of some leguminous plants that fix the nitrogen of the air as well. We have discussed all these: population, community, ecosystem. Growth rates can be affected by disease, predation, availability of food. Okay, the class.